7:36. Muhammad Atta boards American Airlines Flight 11 at Logan International Airport with four other hijackers. 8:14. United Airlines Flight 175 also departs from Logan Airport. Five of the passengers are hijackers. 8:19. Betty Ong, a flight attendant on Flight 11, alerts American Airlines. The cockpit is not answering. Somebody stabbed in business class, and I think there's mace. We can't breathe. I don't know. I think we're getting hijacked. 8:20. American Airlines Flight 77 departs from Washington Dulles International Airport. Five of the passengers aboard are hijackers. 8:42. United Airlines Flight 93 takes off from Newark International Airport with four hijackers aboard. Flight 175 is hijacked. 8:44. Flight attendant Amy Sweeney aboard Flight 11 reports, "Something is wrong. We are in a rapid descent. We're all over the place. I see the water. I see the buildings. I see buildings. We're flying low. We're flying very, very low. We're flying way too low. Oh my God. We're flying way too low." The call ends with a burst of very loud, sustained static. 8:46. Flight 11 crashes into the North Tower of the World Trade Center. 8:49. The first network television and radio reports are broadcast. 8:50. Flight 77 is hijacked. 8:55. President Bush is in an elementary school when he is told that a plane has crashed into the World Trade Center. 8:58. Flight 175 flies toward New York City. 9:02. Evacuation is ordered at the World Trade Center North Tower. 9:03. Flight 175 crashes into the South Tower. Millions see the second impact live. 9:05. President Bush is with elementary students when Chief of Staff Andrew Card interrupts to whisper to the President. A second plane hit the second tower. America is under attack. 9:23. Flight 93 receives a text from United Airlines flight dispatcher. Beware any cockpit intrusion. Two aircraft hit World Trade Center. 9:28. Hijackers storm the cockpit on Flight 93. Take over the flight and fly eastward. 9:37. Flight 77 crashes into the western side of the Pentagon. All 64 people on board and 125 Pentagon personnel are killed. 9:42. The FAA orders the grounding of all civilian air traffic over the United States. 9:57. A passenger revolt begins on Flight 93. 9:59. The South Tower begins to collapse. Moments after it falls, a fire chief in the North Tower orders all firemen to evacuate the building. 10:01. The FAA Command Center advises FAA headquarters that an aircraft saw Flight 93 waving his wings, the hijackers' efforts to defeat the passengers' counterattack. 10:03. United Airlines Flight 93 crashes in a field in Pennsylvania, undoubtedly saving many lives. 10:28. The North Tower begins to collapse. 12:01. 14 people, including 12 firefighters who were in a section of a stairwell in the North Tower that held together during the collapse, climb the stairs to the top of the rubble field and escape with their lives. 3:00. Pasquale Bozzelli, who lost consciousness in a North Tower stairway during the collapse, awakens to find himself lying atop the debris with only a fractured foot. 7:24. Members of Congress join on the steps of the United States Capitol and sing, "God Bless America." 8:30. President Bush addresses the nation from the White House. "Today, our fellow citizens, our way of life, our very freedom came under attack in a series of deliberate and deadly terrorist attacks. Terrorist attacks can shake the foundations of our biggest buildings, but they cannot touch the foundation of America. These acts shatter steel, but they cannot dent the steel of American resolve.